Angus over at MakerSmooth just created an absolutely beautiful macro hotkey keyboard, which he called the Macro Fighter. It's a 3x3 button layout with Sanwa arcade push buttons, but the problem is, there's only one small problem. Well, I let Angus explain what the problem is.
I'm an industrial designer, and I am very skilled at 3D modeling and designing for 3D printing, but I am terrible at code. It's just something I've never been very good at, and I've been trying to push myself to do more projects with actual code, like based on Arduinos and that kind of thing.
Okay, listen, I don't blame him at all, because Angus used the code from Dave and his website Parts Not Included, where Dave has built a similar keyboard, which he called the Stream Deck, I think. And as Angus already said in his video,
his code is gorgeous, but I have no idea how to alter it.
I happen to know a thing or two about Arduino and coding in C and stuff, so I think I'll be able to help him out. In order to help, I first needed my own macro keyboard, just so that I would be able to troubleshoot the code for myself. I wanted to stay as close to Angus's design as possible, but I wanted to use Cherry MX switches instead of Sanwa buttons that he used, because I really liked the tactile feedback of those switches, and those are also the ones that I already had laying around, so I started off by creating a baseplate that would hold the switches in place, after which I modeled the buttons around the switches. These switches have little stems that are perfect for a design that would press fit around those stems. Here I designed the buttons to be translucent, but I decided later on to print them in black because I didn't really like the look of it. But right now it is nice to have them translucent because that way you can see what they look like inside. Then I proceeded by drawing the bottom part. There's nothing really special to say about that, although I did add some registrations for magnets so the top part would be held in place by those magnets. To finish it off, I created some PCB standoffs and a hole for a female USB type B plug and sent it to the printer. I started by printing one single button first just to see if my tolerances were right. And they were, so I printed 9 more, which is admittedly one more than I need, but hey, I like the symmetry of it. I also printed the top and bottom of the case, and the bottom was printed in the same translucent green color and the top was printed in a much darker, heavier green, thinking that those colors would go nicely together, but I'll come back to my choice of colors later on. But first, let's go over the electronics. Both Angus and Dave chose to use an Arduino Pro Micro, which I think is a great choice because it's the smallest Arduino that still complies with the USB 2.0 specification, so I chose this one as well. But I wanted to mount everything on one single PCB. If you want to know the exact dimensions, you should go in the description below where I've linked a Thingiverse page, which I've created, and you'll find all the specifications about that in there.
Thank you.
One thing I'm sure you want me to address right now is why I use the USB type B connector when the Arduino already has a perfectly fine micro USB connector. Well, the reason is very simple, and the reason is that the type B connector, so this connector, is just much more sexy than this dinky little micro USB connector. I don't like this. And if you watch Angus's video, you'll see that he agrees. So, talking about sexy, I designed some recessed holes in both the top and the bottom part of the box for small magnets, which I glued in place with some super glue. Opening and closing the lid with those magnets in place is so satisfying, but I didn't really like the translucent green buttons, so I took them off, unprinted them, and instead printed them in black, which I think looks much better. Okay, now that the keyboard is finished and there's nothing else I can procrastinate with, it's time to talk about the code. The first thing I did was to take a look at Dave's code, just to see how he programmed his macro keyboard. And Angus is absolutely right. His code is gorgeous. The thing is that it's also very beginner unfriendly, because Dave took an object-oriented approach of programming his code. And since programming like that is, in my opinion, way less beginner friendly than if you were to code it linearly, I scrapped Dave's code and I started from scratch. I hope you don't mind, Dave. Your code is beautiful, but I'm just trying to help out at this point. So I'll be doing this as fast as possible. Skip to this time if you're not interested. Let's go. First, we need to include the keyboard library that allows us to simulate the keyboard at all. Then we assign the pins that the buttons are connected to as integers to these global variables. You can name these variables however you like. To make life easier later on, we can put all these variables into one single array like so. Now that all global variables are initialized, we can move on to the setup part of the code. This code only runs once when the Arduino is switched on and is used to set everything up for the main part of the code to run smoothly. Here we can create a small for loop that takes every pin that is saved in our buttons array and sets its pin mode to input pull-up, so that we don't have to add any pull-up or pull-down resistors in between of our buttons. Because someone of you might want to use more or less buttons than the 9 buttons that I'm using, we can let the code count the amount of buttons we specified before and save that amount to a temporary variable, which I'll call button count. This variable can then be used in our for loop. Then we add keyboard.begin like so to start emulating the keyboard. Now we can move on to the loop section. This section will run continuously in a loop and thus is the main part of our code. Here we will continuously monitor if a certain button has been pressed in order to then perform a certain action, or in this case, send a certain hotkey to the computer. So we will add 9 if statements that will each monitor if one of the buttons is being pressed. Inside of these statements, we can now decide what each button will do. The main options to choose from are keyboard write in order to send a certain key, keyboard print to send a word or a sentence, and keyboard press to press a certain button without releasing it. In order to release a certain button, you can then use keyboard release or keyboard release all if you want to release all buttons. In this example, I'll configure the first button to press the Windows key in order to press start on Windows machines, then write the address to my YouTube channel and hit enter. This will open your browser and go directly to my channel. How useful. We will need to add some delays though, because the computer will not be fast enough to register all the keystrokes without those delays. I've skipped over a lot of stuff, but I've added the full code with a lot of useful comments in the Thingiverse post, which I've linked in the description below. Now we have to go to Tools and set the Arduino Micro as the board, and then we have to go to Tools again and select the correct serial port. After connecting the Arduino, just hit the fat arrow on top to compile and upload the code. I've also added some more shortcuts to the other buttons just to show you the capabilities of this keyboard. But this button will do what we just programmed, which is to open my channel. And if you accidentally opened my channel and you want to close it quickly, you can push this button to close it again. Now for the next button, I'll need something to write in. This key will send hello world and lights the LEDs up, which you've seen me add in the B-roll. This one can copy stuff, and the next button will paste. Instead of continuously lighting the LEDs up, this button will instead blink the LEDs for 100 milliseconds. This key opens your task manager, and this one locks your computer. The last two buttons are set up to send Shift and F11 and Shift and F12 to your computer, and are meant to trigger an auto hotkey script. Since AutoHotkey can perform much more powerful tasks than anything that we'll be able to program with an Arduino. This key will, for example, search Google for text that you've highlighted. And the last key will minimize your active window all the way up to the title bar. Oh, shit. As I've said, you can download all the files from my Thingiverse page, which I've linked in the description down below. And I think that this is a really nice project to just get started with Arduino and 3D printing, you know, useful stuff. I mean, everyone is printing these little trinkets and stuff, but where's the fun in that? You want to print useful stuff, that's way better than, you know, stuff like this. Anyways, also make sure to check out Dave's website and Angus's initial video about this keyboard, as they started with the project and I'm just piggybacking off of them. The last thing I want to end on is, well, I don't really make videos that often because I don't really have the time for it. So if you enjoyed this video, you might want to consider subscribing so you won't miss it when I finally get around to uploading my next video. Subscribing is free, so you might as well, right? Anyways, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you soon. Goodbye.